This is the 1938 BSA Empire Star. The Empire Star was pretty well the top of the heap in the 500 single BSA bike in the 30s, leading up to the war. It had that magnificent 8-inch headlight again on it, a lovely speedometer sitting on here, and it had the instruments in the tank. So you had the switch, you had a special emergency light that you could lift off, and it would actually be on the end of a cable so you could walk around the bike and shine a light on places that might be giving you some trouble in the dark. Typical controls laid out on the handlebars, but really nice because it had very short levers on it. A bit unusual because of that. This particular motorcycle is close to my heart because it was really the same model that was my first bike that I had, my first real big motorcycle, that is, and it was a 38 BSA. The interesting thing about the Empire Star is it was raced to considerable success, and we'll find out more about that when we check out another model. But this one here was the top of the heap in its day in a 500 single in the BSA line, and just a gorgeous restoration. I particularly liked the green color on it with the gold pinstriping. Not many motorcycles had that green color, and the green on is a typical British racing green, so it looks really nice on it. Very effective color to use on this motorcycle. One of the neat things on the controls here is on the brake, when you pull the brake on, there's a special little indent that you can push it, and it will become a lock on it so that the bike can be locked and won't just roll away on its own, hopefully. It also has a beautiful exhaust system on it that has a particularly nice muffler on it with fishtail, and that always makes it look a lot better. It also has a lovely toolbox on it too that is very useful on this model.
The Birmingham Small Arms Company, BSA for short, was a British manufacturer of vehicles, firearms, and military equipment. It still exists as an airgun sport manufacturer and distributor. BSA was founded in 1891 in the Gun Quarter, Birmingham, England, by 14 gunsmiths of the Birmingham Small Arms Trade Association. They had supplied arms to the British government during the Crimean War. The company branched out as gun sales declined and began manufacturing the auto dicycle. Not to be confused with bicycles, these inherently unstable conveyances had two large diameter wheels positioned side by side with a seat, pedals, and frame situated between them. They weren't very popular, and in the 1880s, the company began manufacturing bicycles. In 1903, BSA built its first experimental motorcycle. Their first prototype automobile was constructed in 1907. The following year, they sold 150 cars. By 1909, they were offering a number of motorcycles for sale. In 1910, BSA purchased the British Daimler Company for its car engines. During World War I, the company returned to manufacturing arms. BSA produced rifles, Lewis guns, shells, motorcycles, and other vehicles for the war effort. Between 1920 and 1936, BSA produced 3- and 4-wheeled cars along with its line of motorcycles. During World War II, BSA supplied 126,000 M20 motorcycles to the armed forces, plus military bicycles, including a folding paratrooper bicycle. After 1939, Jack Sangster became the managing director of BSA. Post-war, the company continued to expand. In 1951, the BSA group bought Triumph Motorcycles, making them the world's largest motorcycle manufacturer. The Ariel, Sunbeam, and New Hudson motorcycle companies were also acquired. Most of these companies had been owned by Sangster. 1938 marked the year the Empire Star spawned the legendary M34 Gold Star.